So, like in the previous lecture, we had seen this dog family. Now, from the dog family, in dog family, everything was like we were trying to find the high pass filter, and from high pass filter, we were able to reduce, get the low pass filter, the reconstruct the both on the analysis and synthesis side, we were able to get. Now we will try to see how the signal is constructed again exactly. We'll get into the details of signals. So this is the signal on the input side of the input of the filter side. This, then it is nothing. It is something like this. In some sense, the signal at the input side is combination of the scaling function at that point. Okay, so 2 raised power n t convolved with f of n is how the signal is at the input side. When it is passed through the low pass filter and decimated, it looks something like this. So here the signal becomes, now the resolution becomes 1 less, n minus 1 t f less resolution. So let me tell you this, f n, so this will be f of n minus 1 times n. Let me take it m for simplicity, like for some convenience. So this will be 1 resolution less. Or in some sense, here the signal was, I was trying to get here at this point, the signal was, let me tell, f 2 raised power n t or some shrink factor of phi t. Then here it will be some, like if it is phi of 2 t, reconstructed by phi of 2 t, then here the signal will be reconstructed by phi of t, sorry, because it is decimated and done like this. And here the signal on the wavelet side will be reconstructed by phi of t. Are you getting what I am trying to say? So, by this we get, how can I think of this signal? Okay. Think that a signal is reconstructed by phi of 2t. Just think of some, what is, have you heard something like this before? Have you seen something called shifting property? In shifting property, the signal ft is written as the shifted form of the it is written in form of the just cutted form of this deltas. Just read it in some book. So it is similar to shifting property, very similar. So we exploit this similarity in a sense that we are only restricting ourselves to observing the impulse response similar to. So if this is similar to shifting property, this is similar to impulse. In shifting property, we were reconstructing the signal using impulse. Here we are reconstructing the signal using phi of 2t. So think of it as synonymous with impulse. So impulse had impulse response, step has step response. So similarly, phi of 2t has this scaling function as the new scaling function as the response. If this is the low pass filter h of n, this is the high pass filter g of n, then what we can say is that this signal phi of t is equal to phi of 2t convolved with h of n. And this psi of t is this phi of 2t convolved with this g of t. Are you getting this point? So by this, by the simple understanding of how we will do, like similarly, so this is how this will be what we can say. This is equal to phi of t, and this is nothing but this psi of t. So the interesting part, what's the interesting part? The interesting part is that here the signal was constructed by this part, and here the signal is constructed by an expanded form of it. Here, like phi of 2t is what? How is it? It is compressed, and here it is somewhat expanded. So this is what. So the important part here is that here the compressed the reconstruction is by an expanded form. So this is of a lower resolution. And this is of a higher resolution. And here, what overall is happening is that we are getting a lower resolution and a lower resolution and a lower resolution. So the basis of higher to basis of lower, we are able to induce. So that's why we called it as multi-resolution analysis. So that's what, if we are able to get a set of bases by which we are recursively able to get a lower resolution and a lower resolution, so then this way of deriving will lead us to a multi-resolution analysis.